Hello everyone. Now in this lecture we will see step 7, crushing failure of pivot end. In figure, the force P causes compressive stress on a narrow rectangular area of thickness T and width D2 perpendicular to the plane of paper. Therefore, the compressive stress is given by sigma C is equal to P upon area. Area is T into D2. Let's see diagram for pivot end. Here, the stresses is pivot end. We are going to see crushing stress developed in pivot end. Okay, diagram C, 4.13 diagram C. Here, the pivot end, it is the top view of a pivot end. And cotter is inserted in this rectangular slot due to force P at this length, at this thickness, the force is acting. Okay, so this will be a compressive stress for a pivot end. Due to this force, the compressive stress will act at pivot end. Okay, so the area at which the compressive stress is acting is equal to thickness T into diameter D2. Okay, thickness T into diameter D2. Here, let's see, it is a diameter D2 and thickness T. Okay, the diameter D2 is perpendicular to the plane and thickness is the parallel to the plane. Okay, so the area will be T into D2. Into D2, okay, and it is only acting at one plane, so we have taken only T into D2, it is not a double shear. Okay, so the compressive stress will be sigma C is equal to P upon T into D2. Now, next step, step 8, crushing failure of socket end. As shown in figure, the force P causes compressive stress on a narrow rectangular area of thickness T and length equal to d4 minus d2. So the compressive stress in the socket is P upon d4 minus d2 into T. Let's see diagram for socket end. For a socket end, the stresses in socket end for compressive stresses, let's see this diagram. Here, for a socket end, this is a rectangular slot in which we have inserted cotter. Okay, due to force P and the cotter will causes the force at this area. Okay, the thickness is T and the length is perpendicular to this plane. Okay, so the length will be d4. Okay, but only at hatching area, only this area, the stress will induce, because this is empty area. Okay, the cotter will not cause any force to D2, this side. Okay, because this is empty side. For that, you have to see, or you have to imagine, three dimensional diagram for socket end. The three dimensional diagram is given here. See, this is a socket. The socket is a hollow, and so this is a hollow part and there is no material, that's why only we have to consider this area, and this area is equal to d4 minus d2, that is the length is d4 minus d2, means this length plus this length, okay, into thickness, means these two rectangles, d4 minus d2 into thickness is equal to the addition of these two rectangle area. Okay, now step 8, crushing failure of socket end, sigma C is equal to, that is compressive stress is equal to P force upon effective area. Effective area for compressive stress of a socket end is d4 minus d2 into T. Okay, now next step, bending failure of socket cotter. When cotter is tight in pivot, it is subjected to shear stress. Okay, we have seen in step 3, I think in step 3, the shear failure of cotter, right? Step 4, shear failure of cotter. Okay, for that the formula is this. Now we are seeing bending failure of cotter. When cotter is tight in spigot, it is subjected to shear stress, but when it is loose, it is subjected to bending stress, right? When it is tight, it is subjected to shear stress. Mostly the cotter is tight in a cotter joint, but if in any case if it is loose, then it will be subjected to bending stress. Now we have to calculate the bending stress for calculation or determination of bending failure of cotter. Okay, for bending stress we are going to see concept from strength of material subject. The force P between the cotter and spigot end is assumed as uniformly distributed over length d2. The force between socket end and cotter is assumed to be varying linearly from 0 to maximum with triangular distribution. Okay, for that you we will see the diagram for same, so you will understand it very well. The cotter is treated as beam. Okay, first we will see the diagram. Here it is, diagram bending stress in cotter. See, it is a cotter. Okay, this is a cotter placed in horizontal position. Okay, here you have to assume, we have to imagine the spigot end. Okay, spigot end will be here, and the force due to spigot end acting at cotter will be like downward. For this diagram will be downward. Okay, this spigot end will cause uniform distribution of forces. Okay, uniform distribution of forces. Socket, you already know that socket end is a hollow. Okay, and there is upper part and lower part, we have seen in another diagram for a socket end. Okay, so in this case the socket will touch cotter at this point. Okay, at this point and this length, these two length, from this to this length and from this to this length, the socket will touch the cotter. Okay, and the socket will causes force in upward direction in this only diagram. Okay, cause upward direction. The socket will touch mainly at this point and this point, so the maximum force will be at this point, and this force will be decreased linearly up to this point. Okay, the socket will touch here also, but the force will be linearly decreasing. Likewise, the socket will cause triangular distribution at this side also, and the maximum force here is maximum, while the force will linearly decrease throughout this length. Okay, so the distribution of force will be triangular for socket end side, and distribution of force will be uniformly distribution for spigot end side. Okay, so the force is P from spigot end, that is total force P, and from socket end the total force P. Okay, here the P is distributed for two sides of the socket end, that is P by 2 and P by 2. Now this is a force diagram. Now we have to analyze it. The uniform distribution of this force have to take it as, let first draw a center line here. Draw center line. Now this uniform distribution of force is distributed for in two parts, that is left part and right part. This uniform distribution of this force of left part is assumed to be at one point, only one point. If we have to convert this uniform distribution into point load, then we, for a uniform distribution, that is a rectangular distribution, we have to take a point load at center point, right? In some subject it is taught that the point load will act at center point. Okay, so P by 2 force will act at center point, and likewise this P by 2 force will also act at this P by 2 force will also act at center point. Okay, so there will be two point load act. Okay, the distance between center line to the point of load acting is z, small z. Okay, we will calculate it later. So this is the force due to spigotin. Now force due to triangular distribution, that is force due to socket end, the first part is this P by 2. This triangular distribution, distributed load is converted into point load, and the point of action is, we know that the for triangular distribution, the distance from this larger side to the point of action is 1/3 of this total length, right? 1/3 of this total length. Suppose this total length is y, small y, then 1/3 of this total length will be y by 3, and assuming that y by 3 is equal to small x, so the small x distance from this point to this point, and small x distance from this point to this point, okay, the distance is small x, at which the point load P by 2 is acting. P by 2 is acting. Okay, so this force, this downward force and upward force will cause moment about this line, and this downward force and upward force will cause moment about this line. So we have to calculate this moment to calculate the bending stress acting at quarter. Okay, for this simplification, quarter is treated as beam. Okay, this first diagram is actual distribution of forces, and second diagram is simplified diagram of forces. Okay, this is actual distribution of forces, this is simplified diagram of forces. This is a cross section of quarter having thickness T, width B. Okay, now see, the force P between the quarter and spigotin is assumed as uniformly distributed over length D2. The force between socket end and quarter is assumed to be varying linearly from 0 to maximum with triangular distribution. I have told you reason for this. Now the quarter is treated as beam. For triangular distribution, the x, small x, is equal to 1/3 of y. Okay, the y is, the value of y, small y, is equal to d4 minus d2 upon 2. D4 minus d2 upon 2. The 1/3 of d4 minus d2 upon 2 will be d4 minus d2 upon 6. So the value of small x will be d4 minus d2 upon 6. The bending moment is maximum at the center. At central section, the bending moment will be the force P by 2 into distance. Distance is equal to d2 by 2 plus x. Okay, minus P by 2 into z. For that, we will see a diagram again. The moment will, we are considering moment at the center line. Okay, so first we will see the right side force, right side of this plane force. This is a plane, central plane. The right side of central plane will be these two forces. Okay, so P by 2 into z plus, okay, this is a plus because this moment will cause clockwise, this force will cause clockwise moment, and this force will cause anti-clockwise moment. So P by 2 into z minus P by 2 into this length plus x. Okay, this length is d2 by 2. Okay, d2 by 2 plus x. So P by 2 into d2 by 2 plus x minus P by 2 into z. So from वी विल सी इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर.